Star 40, and this is Celebrity Top 10. We give you the latest, the juiciest, and the hottest entertainment news, ba pa local man o international. Yan ang hatadamin sa inyo because here's a countdown. You shouldn't miss the new normal. You can't resist. Let's start with today's number 10. So Netflix gave us a look of Cowboy Bebop. Bing, bing, bing. Wow, I saw this last night and it's a much awaited live action reboot of Cowboy Bebop and it's arriving real soon, November that is. So Netflix has released a first look on the reboot of the 90s anime series. Starring John Cho, Jet Black, and Faye Valentine, the story revolves around a team of hunty bounters ready to hunt down criminals in space. Bing, bing, bing. Production started in 2019, but it did stop due to the pandemic. Now, Cowboy Bebop is dropping come November. Number 9, people. Aerosmith partners with Universal Music Group. Legendary American rock band Aerosmith has sealed a partnership with Universal Music Group. UMG is expected to bring the discography, merchandise, audio, video projects of the band together. Expect more details from the UMG about their collab with Aerosmith. The band was founded in Boston in the 1970s and became one of the most influential and successful bands in the world. Among their hits is I Don't Wanna Close My Eyes. Shut up. I don't wanna miss a thing. Duh. I'm sure you wanted to sing that too. Anyway, next number. So Cynthia Erivo stars in Needle in a Time Stamp. Oscar nominee Cynthia Erivo has been announced as the lead star of Needle in a Time Stamp, and it is a movie based on a classic sci-fi novel by Robert Silverberg. It's directed by John Ridley, and it is a science fiction drama about a married couple in a world where there is time travel. Cynthia is joined by Leslie Odom Jr. and Orlando Bloom. Needle in a Time Stack is premiering come October. So Rolling Stones' Charlie Watts passed away at the age of 80. Bing, bing, bing. Charlie Watts, drummer of the legendary band Rolling Stones, did pass away in London. No cause of death was mentioned. He was 80 years old. The news broke out by a statement from the band and Charlie's spokesperson. Charlie was described as a cherished husband, father, and grandfather, and one of the greatest drummers of their generation. He was also described as the nicest gent you could ever meet. They are also requesting for privacy at this time. Prior to this, Charlie was about to join the Rolling Stones upcoming U.S. tour, ding, ding, ding. But he withdrew ahead of time because he needed to recover from a recent medical procedure that was not mentioned. In 2004, though, it can be remembered that he was treated for throat cancer. Charlie first joined the Rolling Stones in 1963 with Mick Jagger, Brian Jones, and Keith Richards. All right, number 6 for the Swifties. Taylor Swift joins TikTok. So she is officially a TikToker. Bing, bing, bing. Former country singer turned pop star posted her first TikTok video promoting the vinyl edition of her forthcoming album, Red. Her fans went crazy with the additional social media platform of their idol, and they were, of course, looking forward to seeing more TikTok videos from the singer. Maybe some heartbreak TikTok trends, huh? So anyway, guys, they're really looking forward, right? So they even use the hashtag SwiftTalk so that followers and fans can easily see posts or content related to Taylor. Now, if you're the only one who hasn't seen Taylor's first TikTok yet, we're dropping it right here.
Discussions, six-figure discussions, dinners in public, my linen all tailored, my outstanding payments, swift like Taylor, and boy, I owe them men a beating.
All right, before we move on, I want to say hi to the All In Addicts, the OMJ supporters. Hello to you guys. Thank you for being here. Also, we're 4:15 p.m. in One News. Replays at 10:30 p.m. in 1 p.h. Also, we're on Facebook, guys. Don't forget about that. And YouTube as well, so you can watch us anytime, anywhere in the world. Also, you can read up on onenews.ph. We post the top 10 1 hour after we go live. So yeah, number five, we're going local with this headline. Rep. Ismael Toto Maudadatu marries beauty queen. Miss Asia Pacific International 2018 Sharifa Akil got married to Maguindanao 2nd District Representative Ismael Maudadatu. The announcement was posted on Facebook of the National Commission of Muslim Filipinos Bureau of External Relations. Just last year, the beauty queen became controversial when she was rumored to have an affair with Representative Maudadatu. Muntinlupa City 1st District Councilor Mylene Maligaya Maudadatu, also a former beauty queen and wife. Yes, or then wife. Even took this to Rafi Tulfo's Wanted sa Radio, where Sharifa and the congressman denied to take the calls. Sharifa answered via Facebook post, while she did not name Mylene, Sharifa said, "Do not blame me for your failed marriage and your failed life." She also insisted that she never needed to compete with anyone, that she has worked hard for whatever she has achieved. All right. Okay. American singer Sahara covers an OPM song. So international recording artist Sahara releases a single, which is the cover of the OPM song Dahil Ba Sa Kanya. And it was originally sung by Jaya. According to Sahara, she felt connected to the song because it's emotions lingered in her heart. Hence, she took time to learn it and eventually recorded and released it. She even spoke to the composer, Freddy Saturno, to ask his permission to cover the song. Apart from Jaya's hit, Sahara has also said she felt attached to the OPM in general. Yes, so shall we see her covering more Filipino songs soon? Anyway, if you don't know her, Sahara gave us the version of Dahil Ba Sa Kanya, and it's available in all digital streaming platforms, but of course here in Celebrity Top 10, we're gonna give you a glimpse so you'll have an idea. Watch this.
Dahil na ba sa kanya, nakalimutan mo aking sinta, ang sabi mo noon hanggang wakas, tayong dalawa ay magsasama. Dahil na ba sa kanya, naririto ako'y nag-iisa. Pag-ibig mo sa akin ba ay naglaho na?
Alright. We spoke with Jahna Gibbs and he shared some fun facts about his latest film. Another controversial movie with Viva, directed by Daryl Yap, is about to be seen next week via Viva Max.
Ding, ding, ding.
Ninth film for him, okay? The title itself is really intriguing. It's 69 plus 1. It is a story of two LGBT couple who are looking for a man who will satisfy and make their relationship even hotter. They're having the 7-year itch. So this concept of a throuple or three as a couple is being introduced in the local scene here in the Philippines. It has been going on, of course, worldwide already, but we're giving a spotlight in the media for it via this film. And that'll, yeah, of course. I had an interview with Jahna Gibbs and he shared some juicy info about the movie.
Ding, ding, ding.
Direct Daryl called me. I reached out to him. Tapos sinabi niya outright. Na I wasn't his choice for the movie. Because, tinanong ko kung bakit, because daw, he needed, parang ang peg niya, an attractive guy. Parang,
yes!
Parang, kumbaga, sabi niya, hindi ka naman pangit eh. So, pero gusto ni Boss Vic, ikaw ang ilagay doon.
Alright. Jimmy Alapag signs with NBA G League. So Pinoy basketball star Jimmy Alapag is still in the running for the NBA ranks as he gets hired as assistant coach with G League's Stockton Kings, a team affiliated to Sacramento Kings. He will serve under the head coach and ex-NBA player Bobby Jackson. Just last week, people, Jimmy helped propel the Sacramento Kings win in the NBA Summer League in Las Vegas, when he also played assistant coach to the team. In that game, the Kings scored 100-67 over Boston Celtics, completing a perfect 5-0 run in the NBA preseason games. On the other hand, another hot news from another Filipino athlete. Filipino cager PBA star Bobby Ray Parks Jr. just inked a one-year contract with Japan B-League's Nagoya Diamond Dolphins.
Ding, ding, ding.
They're just waiting for the former TNT guard's medical clearance for his contract to become official. Congratulations! Number one! Spider-Man No Way Home teaser trailer released. Yes, it is a big deal. After months of leaked videos and even fans making up trailers, finally the official trailer has been dropped.
Ding, ding, ding.
Here Tom Holland reprises his role as Peter Parker, aka Spider-Man, but he is now joined by another Marvel hero, Doctor Strange, played by Benedict Cumberbatch.
Ding, ding, ding.
The teaser trailer revealed some interesting scenes and comeback villains from the previous Spider-Man movies. That came after with very apt with its caption in the Facebook that what just happened. Fans are guessing that rumors might be true in regards to the joining of forces of former Spider-Man actors as well as stars who portrayed as villains.
Ding, ding, ding.
Well, let's see how this one goes. Spider-Man No Way from No Way Home premieres December and will be available in 4 languages: English, Hindi, Tamil, and Telugu.
Ding, ding, ding.
Wow! Before we end, everybody, just a general reminder, we're all safe from COVID-19. Wear a mask, disinfect, practice social distancing, get vaccinated! That's it for today. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Makilista makikountdown Mondays to Fridays, 4:15 p.m. on One News with replays in 1 p.h. 10:30-ish. But after that, you can also catch us on onenews.ph. Read up on that if you're the type. We're also an online, guys. Anyway, I'm MJ Marfori. Thank you so much for joining me. This is Celebrity Top 10. Ta-ta!